Hey Lifesavers and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nurse Kelly Tyrrell and in today's video we are going to be covering a process called dimensional analysis, which will make solving medication conversion and calculation questions a complete breeze. But before we jump into the video, make sure you subscribe to my channel, like, comment, and share this video with a friend, and make sure you click that bell icon to turn on notifications so you don't miss out on my upcoming content. If you're not sure what dimensional analysis is or how it can help you simplify nursing math calculations, then I suggest that you keep watching. So what exactly is dimensional analysis? Well, the technical definition of dimensional analysis is a problem-solving technique where measurements are converted to equivalent units of measure by multiplying a given unit of measurement by a fractional form of one to obtain the desired unit of administration. I'm going to simplify this. So basically what this means is that you're using measurements from the metric table and you're converting them to the desired unit by multiplying straight across the top, straight across the bottom, and then you're dividing the equation to achieve your desired unit in its simplest form. Still confused? I know, I was too at first. So let's go ahead and do a simple practice question so that way we can tie this all together. Before we jump into this example, I want to emphasize that in order to use this type of formula to work out equations, it's going to be so imperative that you memorize the metric table. So here's an example of what a standard metric table looks like. Okay, so let's try a simple example to tie this together. Let's say we are preparing to administer a weight-based medication to a pediatric patient, and we need to convert his weight from pounds to kilograms. For example, our patient weighs 27 pounds. So how would we convert from pounds to kilograms using this dimensional analysis? So first, we should have memorized that there are 2.2 pounds in every 1 kilogram. So using dimensional analysis, our problem would look something like this. So the formula we're using here is patient weight over 1, or sometimes you'll see it written over a question mark. Then what we're going to do is multiply it by the given unit of measurement from the metric table. Now this step is really important, so make sure that you're listening. You'll want to make sure that the unit from the metric table on the bottom of the second half of the equation matches the unit from the top half of the first part of the equation. So that way the two units can cancel each other out. So see here how I have pounds on the top in the first part of the equation, and then I have pounds diagonally on the bottom in the second part of the equation. We have to do this so that way the units cancel each other out, and we know once we do that, we will be solving for our end unit or desired unit, which in this example is going to be kilograms. So think dimensional and diagonal. They both start with D. So next we're going to multiply straight across the top and then straight across the bottom. So 27 times 1 equals 27, and 1 times 2.2 equals 2.2. Now the last step is we have to divide the numbers, so we're going to take 27 divided by 2.2, and voila, you will get 12.27 kilograms or 12.3 if you round to the nearest tenth. All right, let's try a few more just to get the hang of it. So let's say you need to convert 0.7 milligrams of dioxin to micrograms. So we know because we've memorized our metric table that there are 1,000 micrograms in every 1 milligram. So now let's set up our problem. So our formula here is going to be our supply dose over 1 times the given unit of measurement from the metric table. So in this case, our problem should look something like this. Again, I want to note that our milligrams are now going to cancel each other out because we place them on opposite sides and diagonal from each other. So since milligrams now cancel out, our desired measurement, micrograms, is what will be left. So now we can go ahead and keep going. All right, so next we want to multiply straight across the top and then straight across the bottom. So 0.75 times 1,000 is 750, and 1 times 1 is 1. Now our last step is we need to divide 750 by 1, so our final answer is going to be 750 micrograms. Okay, so now that we're getting a little more comfortable with simple conversions, let's really test our knowledge and skills and move on to two-step dimensional analysis conversion problems. Okay, let's say we need to convert 0.025 grams into micrograms. We just did milligram to microgram, but now we're going to convert grams to micrograms. So if you look at our metric chart, you'll see that there is no simple conversion for gram to microgram, but we do see that we have a gram to milligram conversion, and we have a milligram to microgram conversion. So this is why this problem is going to require two steps. All right, so let's start by setting up this problem. So we are going to take 0.025 grams over 1 times 1,000 milligrams over 1 gram. Now, if we left the problem like this, it would be solving for milligrams, but we actually need to solve for micrograms. So in this case, we need to take it one step further in order to finish setting up this problem. So to finish setting this problem up, we are going to add the 1,000 micrograms over a milligram. So we're going to times our first part of our equation by the 1,000 micrograms over 1 milligram. So again, see how I put the milligram units diagonal to each other? So now you can see that grams will cancel out as well as milligrams, leaving us with our desired unit of measurement, which is micrograms. All right, now let's get to work solving this problem. So the first thing we are going to do is multiply all the numbers on the top and then multiply all the numbers on the bottom. So on the top, we have 0.025 times 1,000 times 1,000, which gives you 25,000. And on the bottom, we have 1 times 1 times 1, which equals 1. And then our last step is to divide the two numbers together. So 25,000 divided by 1, which equals 25,000 micrograms. Okay, so let's take this up a notch and see how we can apply this methodology to an actual NCLEX style question. So this is an example of a question that you may find on the NCLEX, which you will use this dimensional analysis theory to help you achieve the correct answer. So the question reads, a client who weighs 176 pounds is being immunosuppressed by daily maintenance doses of cyclosporin to prevent organ transplant rejection. The dose prescribed is 8 milligrams per kilogram each day. How many milligrams should the nurse administer each day? Okay, so this is a very typical and standard question that you may see. So you're trying to figure out how much medication to administer based on an ordered dose of 8 milligrams per kilogram, and you have a patient who weighs 176 pounds. So the first thing we are going to want to do is break down this problem into two parts. First, we need to convert the patient's weight to kilograms because the prescribed dose of our medication is based on milligrams per kilogram. All right, so using dimensional analysis, we're going to set up the weight conversion part of the problem like this. You're going to take 176 pounds over 1 times 1 kilogram over 2.2 pounds. So pounds will now cancel out, and we can take 176 times 1 equals 176, and 1 times 2.2 equals 2.2. We divide the numbers together, so 176 divided by 2.2, which equals 80 kilograms. All right, so now let's figure out the second part to this question using dimensional analysis. So we will need to administer 8 milligrams per kilogram to our patient who weighs 80 kilograms. So to do this, you're going to use the formula weight times ordered dose. So you want to set up the problem just like this. 80 kilograms over 1 times 8 milligrams over 1 kilogram. You'll see the kilograms cancel out, so we have 80 times 8, which equals 640, and 1 times 1 equals 1. So again, the last step is to divide the two numbers, so 640 divided by 1 will give us our final solution of 640 milligrams. So that's it, you guys. It's that easy. You're going to become a pro at these calculations in no time. The best advice I can give you is to memorize that metric table and all of the most common nursing conversions. Trust me, it is going to help you significantly when you're working out these types of problems. And also, just make sure you're taking your time. Remember that dimensional analysis is diagonal, and lastly, you want to have confidence in yourself. Practice doesn't always make perfect, but it makes it easier, so stick with it and keep practicing. Make sure you tune into my upcoming videos because we're going to tackle a lot more of these calculation questions. And that concludes the end of this lesson. I hope that you found this information extremely valuable and it made you just a little more confident as you prepare to take your NCLEX or your next nursing school exam. I just want to thank you all again so much, Lifesavers, for tuning in today. My name is Nurse Kelly Tyrrell, and I help nurses feel more confident, increase their test scores, and retain what they don't remember in nursing school. Speaking of, are you a nursing student or soon to be or ready to take your NCLEX? If so, have you joined my online student community yet? If not, then what are you waiting for? The UNursity community is a complete nursing resource hub all at your fingertips. Inside, you can expect to receive coaching, community, and content. You'll get daily coaching with your mobile mentor, me, Nurse Kelly Tyrrell. You'll also receive access to weekly educational videos that you can watch months before they even publish to YouTube. You'll also get exclusive printable digital downloads like worksheets, quizzes, flashcards, infographics, cheat sheets, skills checklists, and more. And if this video helped you in any way, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and click that notification bell so you don't miss out on my upcoming content. Also, if you can do me a favor and drop me a comment below, let me know where you're at with your nursing journey. I'd love to just say hi and connect with you. Also, make sure you click that share icon to spread the word and encourage a fellow aspiring nurse. And last but not least, when you are ready to take your NCLEX, be sure to check out my NCLEX and Chill review, where I review detailed test-taking strategies and cover every major topic that you can expect to find on the NCLEX. If you want to have that unfair advantage and pass your NCLEX on your very next attempt, be sure to click the link in the description box below. Not ready to end the study sesh yet? Well, you are in luck, because if you stick around, you can watch more of my videos coming at you in 3, 2, 1. Bye, Lifesavers.